Hi everyone, I'm Sheila Tan. I'm a meta coach and a neurosemantics trainer. When someone says, I'm afraid of confrontation, there's a high probability that the person is also passive aggressive. So passive aggressive are like two extremes of a continuum. And this is very cultural for Filipinos as well. So passive is I suffer silently. And then if I can't take it anymore, either I go to aggressive, and that may be in the form of sometimes gossip, backstabbing, or I explode, I can't take it anymore, I'm just gonna leave. Or sometimes they scream at the person all of a sudden after months or years of accumulation. And the solution is actually the midpoint, which is being assertive. So, and now the question is, how do I become assertive, right? First is I suggest to change the term, because confrontation seems to have like so much negative energy around it, right? Like it's such a big thing. So instead of confrontation, think about it as a conversation. Can I have a conversation with you? And learning to communicate well is one of the things that we'll have to work on so that we could be assertive in a way that's not offensive. If we work on being assertive, then now we can handle conversations, discussions, disagreements, and to an extreme, confrontations as well. When the person feels attacked, then there's a need to defend, right? So framing is very important. So for example, instead of saying, let's talk about the mistake that you made, because that makes a person build walls around them. Instead of that, let's talk about how we can make this better, or talk about an objective that you both have. So you could say, for example, people from different departments, finance and marketing, or sales and finance, usually people who would like bump head to head with each other. So let's just align that where we have the same objective, which is, I don't know, grow bottom line together or something, achieve a certain goal. And for the person to understand that this is not to tell you what's wrong or what you did wrong, but how we can make it improve, how can we work on it together. It's very important for us to focus on what the person did instead of judging the person. So instead of saying evaluative words or judgment words like, the problem with you is you're always negative, or the problem with you is you make a big deal out of everything. Instead of that, we want to focus on what they said. So you said this, you did this, and this is the consequence, or this is how it appeared to me. And is that what you meant? Something like that.